Welcome indoor cycling fans for stage 14 on my Veloton Beta Grand Tour. Today's stage is almost 38 kilometers. And as the stage profile shows, completely a flat stage. Like I said in my previous video, curious to see how the AI will respond on these flat stages. As some of you might know, at the start of my Veloton Grand Tour, I had a lot of difficulties on these flat stages. Luckily, I have more than 3 minutes in front of the rest of the favorites. Already there's a group of four riders trying to break away. Still in the green and polka dot jersey as well. Some more riders joining the breakaway. So far, in the peloton, pace is pretty slow.
Allez les gars, allez go go go, allez on y va.
On continue, courage. Continue comme ça. Allez les gars, courage.
I really want to find a place where I can stay in the peloton. I think it's still not that easy. And this is the result. Falling behind for the first time, just like on my first few stages. Almost gone, was already in support from the start, trying to bring me back. Maybe this is the first warning. As you can see, even with the help of Moscon, it takes a while to bring me back. So, this was definitely not part of my plans for today. Moscon now pushing hard out of the saddle. Joining with the peloton. Again, I'm falling behind instantly. Okay, the gap is not that big, so looks like I will close in shortly. Here I am, back together with the peloton. just takes a while in Veloton before my rider responds. That's often the reason why I get dropped. Okay, I should be more up front as well. It often comes as a surprise when the peloton attacks.
Et voilà! Bravo les gars, c'est bien!
Bravo les gars! Continuez comme ça! Allez les gars, courage!
Allez les gars, continuez ça!
Goes to Greipel, Boasson-Hagen, Van Avermaet and Willis. Looks like I've started to find my rhythm. I'm pushing on once again. Again, I'm falling behind. Gap with the peloton now 17 seconds. Only 5 seconds behind on the first group. By little, I'm closing in. Still the time gap, 19 seconds, so time difference even increasing right now. already at the start, this race is definitely on. Hamilton caught up with the first group. So in front, everyone's back together. So maybe this is the time to get back to the front. 16 seconds. Riders trying to break away once again. Neuberger, Arendt. Now we're 6 seconds in front of the peloton. And at last. Caught up, or at least almost. I succeeded. Just around the 7.4 kilometer mark. And now we make a big jump in the race. 0.1 kilometers left to go, 20.8 kilometers into this race. And now I'm in the front. Definitely a better position to be in. Difference with the first group is 38 seconds. But to me, the AI felt a lot harder on this flat stage compared to the mountain stages. Now we're nearing the intermediate sprint. One kilometer left to go. Six riders up front, but I can still grab a few points for that green jersey. Although I don't think I'm still able to lose it. Yeah, 1 meter left to go. Starting to speed things up, not really sprinting. It's like no one is going for the sprint. Okay, grabbing some points once again, strengthening my position. Now some crosswinds. This makes me fall behind instantly, although I'm pushing on. As I said earlier, there's a small time gap in between the reaction of my rider and myself. So once again, I get caught by surprise. I'm being dropped once again. On the right, you see the yellow jersey ranking. Being all 3 minutes and 6 seconds behind. Castor Viejo helping me out, but he's not doing much. Although I ordered him to close the gap. Time difference 17 seconds. Definitely looks like I'm in trouble right now. And after those pretty easy mountain stages, I didn't expect the AI to be this strong. Just wish that Castor Viejo was doing more work. It's not really helping me out. Close for a second there, close to the back of the peloton. It's so hard to get back with this wind. I'm all by myself. Castor Viejo is now even 3 seconds behind. a way I can manage the time gap with the peloton. Still 17 seconds. Little by little, the peloton is getting further away. Time difference 27 seconds. Once again, 3 minutes and 6 seconds in front of Pinot. But with 10 kilometers left to go, things are looking serious. And all of a sudden there's a Castroviejo. Instead of staying close to me, just rides off. Pretty annoying. Took was one surprise attack from the peloton at the start of that crosswind. The rider just reacting a little bit too late.
Allez, 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 allez
Just remember, I got no support whatsoever from Castelviejo, and now he's at 31 seconds in front of me. I could definitely use some help. Maybe it's because Thomas and Bernal are still up front. Thomas in a third position, and Bernal in a fifth position on the general classification, so maybe that's why. Maybe this will help, because this camera angle gives you a nice sense of speed. With the peloton, almost 2 minutes. I'm doing more or less 350 watts, the time difference decreases, but it instantly increases once again as soon as I slow down. So for me it's impossible to fight back. I can control the damage. It definitely looks like I'm losing a lot of time.
Courage, continue! allez, 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 les gars,
allez, 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 allez,
allez,
allez,
allez, allez, allez, allez, allez, allez, allez, allez,
allez, a little too late, but now we must come. He's in the effort group. Now it's way too late for some support. They're starting to look serious right now. Almost 2 minutes and 40 seconds behind on the peloton. 4.4 kilometers left to go. Really feels like the peloton wants to bring back the excitement into this tour. Already starting to think about the next race. Maybe be a part of the early breakaway once again, just like I did in my first couple of races. Nearing the 3 minute mark. Something I didn't expect possible anymore is becoming more and more real. That's Pinot once again in the yellow jersey. Time gap now 3 minutes and 1 second. See the ranking once again. There you see those 3 minutes and 1 and 6 seconds. And here he is, way too late, Moscon. Ordering him to help me out once again. And then this happens. I'm really upset with Moscon at this moment. Got no help from him during the entire race. And then he just sprints off like a rocket. And at least 500 or 600 watts.
Allez, allez,
allez, allez, allez, allez, allez,
allez, allez,
allez, allez, allez, difference with the Peloton, 3 minutes, 1 second. 1.6 kilometers left to go. Can I keep the yellow jersey? I'm really trying at the moment. Hard. Whoa. 1 kilometer left to go. Time difference reaching the 3 minute mark once again. Now I'm feeling tired. Push. As you can see on the right, it's not possible for me to take back a few seconds. Even when I'm doing almost 350 watts. At this moment, I'm still in the yellow jersey. Now Pinot takes over. It's a big surprise after this stage. Pinot in the yellow jersey. You see it well. 9 seconds in front, so losing a lot of precious time today, and of course I'm still well in front for the green and polka dot jersey, but not so satisfied with how this stage went. It was a really hard stage for me. So hopefully I can get the jersey back in the next stage. Here you see it. There's one climb, so maybe that's an opportunity. 27.6 kilometers. and a one climb totally at the end. But that's for the next stage. I really hope you enjoyed this stage, guys. Hope to see you all again for stage 15.